Good evening, viewers. Welcome to another episode of The Week in Review, where we bring you a wrap of key developments that occurred in the Nigerian economy, financial and capital market for the previous week. We'll be looking at the federal government's extension of the ease of lockdown by another 4 weeks, Debt Management Office provision of clarifications on loans Nigeria has received from China, the Central Bank of Nigeria's issuing of guidelines on its health research grants, Lagos State's review of its land use charge, and policymakers and regulators and stakeholders also lauding Institute of Directors of Nigeria on its revised code of ethics. We begin with the story during the week that President Muhammadu Buhari approved the extension of the second phase of the ease lockdown in Nigeria for another 4 weeks. This was disclosed by Mr. Boss Mustafa, Secretary to the Government of the Federation and Chairman of the Presidential Task Force on COVID-19. This was during the briefing it gave in Abuja. President Buhari had a meeting during the week with the task force to review the developments around the COVID-19 pandemic and how Nigerians are aligning with the protocol. The task force at the end of the meeting briefed its president on the progress made in containing the spread of COVID-19. Mr. Boss Mustafa said the PTF made some recommendations to the president and the extension of the current ease of lockdown was one of the recommendations approved during the meeting. Under the revised guidelines of the ease lockdown, which will be maintained in the next 4 weeks, the current nationwide curfew from 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. will still stand. Also, meetings for government officials and parastatals will continue to hold virtually. While the ban on entertainment centers will be maintained, there will be restrictions on recreational parks, which have been lifted for non-contact physical activities. Passengers arriving for domestic flights can now arrive at least an hour and a half before the flight time and 3 hours before the flight for international travelers. In the wake of debates over loans Nigeria has received from China, the Debt Management Office issued a statement on the status of loans and what it has been used for. According to DMO Nigeria, the total borrowing from China is currently $3.121 billion. This amount represents only 3.94% of Nigeria's total public debt, which is $79.3 billion as of March 31, 2020. Similarly, in terms of external sources of funds, loans from China accounted for 11.28% of the external debt stock of $27.67 billion that Nigeria has at the same date. This data shows that China is not a major source of funding for the Nigerian government, according to DMO. The total borrowing from China, which is $3.121 billion as of March 31, 2020, are concessional loans with interest rates of 2.5% per annum and tenor of 20 years and grace period of moratorium of 7 years. The terms and other details of the loans are available at the DMO website. These terms are in compliance with the provisions of Section 41, Subsection 1A at the Fiscal Responsibility Act of 2007. In addition, the low interest rate reduces the interest cost to government, while the long tenor enables the repayment of the principal sum of the loans over many years. These two benefits make the provisions for debt service in an annual budget lower than they would otherwise have been if the loans were on commercial terms. The $3.121 billion loans are project-tied loans that Nigeria has received from China. They have about 11 key projects, which include amongst the following: Nigeria Railway Modernization Project in Idu-Kaduna section, Abuja Light Rail Project, Nigeria's 4 airport terminals expansion, which include Abuja, Kano, Lagos, and Port Harcourt, Nigeria Railway Modernization Project, which includes Lagos-Ibadan section, and the rehabilitation and upgrading of the Abuja Kefi Makurdi Road project. The impact of these loans is not only evident but visible, according to DMO Nigeria. For instance, the Idu-Kaduna rail line has become a major source of transportation between Abuja and Kaduna. Also, the new international airport in Abuja has improved air transportation for the populace, while the Lagos-Ibadan rail line, when completed, will ease traffic on the busy Lagos-Ibadan expressway. During the week, the Lagos state government reviewed the land use charge law by reversing the rates to pre-2018 regime, thereby undertaking reforms to reduce financial pressure on citizens and accommodating the agitations of Lagosians in respect of the exorbitant rates. The Commissioner for Finance, Dr. Rabi Olowo, who revealed this during the week in a press conference held at the Bagauda Cultural Press Center in Alausa, Ikeja, disclosed that the penalties for 2017, 2018, and 2019 have been waived, which translates to over 5 billion naira potential revenue relinquished by the state government. It also revealed that multiple payment channels for the collection of the land use charge have also been created by the ministry to further ease the mode of payment, including the use of online channels. Dr. Lowo maintained that the downward review and reforms of the land use charge shows that the Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu administration is concerned about ameliorating the financial pressure on Lagosians, especially during this pandemic period. According to him, in 2018, there was an increase in land use charge rates as well as the method of valuation of property. This twin shock had a sporadic increase in land use charge payable by property owners. However, this present administration decided to review the land use charge law by reversing the rate of land use charge to pre-2018 regime, upholding the 2018 method of valuation. Speaking further, he said some of the new reforms introduced include the exemption of property owned and property occupied by pensioner from paying land use charge, reduction in the percentage increase in penalties for defaults in paying the LUC in the following categories: 45 to 75 days from 25% to 10%, 75 to 105 days from 50% to 20%, and 105 to 135 days from 100% to 50%. The commissioner also announced a 48% reduction in the annual charge rates, just as the annual rate for agricultural land was reduced from 0.076% to 0.01%, which represents an 87% reduction from the old rate. Also during the week, the Central Bank of Nigeria released its guidelines for health research and grants to tackle the COVID-19 pandemic. The broad objectives of the scheme include providing grants for research and development in new or revalidation of drug molecule, phytomedicines and fast vaccines for the control, prevention and treatment of infectious diseases in Nigeria, boosting domestic manufacturing of validated drugs, herbal medicines and vaccines for the control, prevention and treatment of infectious diseases in Nigeria, and reduce the nation's dependence on other countries for these drugs and vaccines, improving the capacity of the biotechnological and pharmaceutical companies, institutions, researchers and research institutes in the development of approved Nigerian drugs, herbal medicines and vaccines for infectious diseases, supporting capacity of relevant health agencies towards attaining World Health Organization maturity level 3, a prerequisite for manufacturing of vaccines in Nigeria, facilitating partnership between academia and the research community in terms of developing drugs, phytomedicines and vaccines for the control, prevention and treatment of infectious diseases in Nigeria, and reducing the dependency on imported drugs, products and vaccines for the control, prevention and treatment of infectious diseases in Nigeria. According to the CBN, activities eligible for consideration under the scheme include research and development of candidate drugs, herbal medicines and vaccines validated by relevant health authorities for the control, prevention and treatment of infectious diseases, manufacturing of drugs, herbal medicines and vaccines validated by relevant health authorities for the control, prevention and treatment of infectious diseases, red biotechnological research and development in new health technology for the control, prevention and treatment of infectious diseases, research partnership between academia and industry into the development of drugs and vaccines for the control, prevention and treatment of infectious diseases, research and development into validated phytomedicines for the control, prevention and treatment of infectious diseases. The Institute of Directors of Nigeria during the week also unveiled its revised code of ethics for its members and stakeholders. At the event, the Minister of Industries, Trade and Investment, Otumbani Adebayo, commended the IOD for establishment of the revised code of ethics, which he described as a step in the right direction which will boost investor confidence, improve business environment and encourage investment in Nigeria. He also commended the IOD Nigeria for instilling high-level ethics and governance for its members and stakeholders in the economy. Chairman of the occasion, His Excellency Dr. Christopher Kolade, described directors as stewards of other people's investments, started with the responsibility of effective management of resources. He re-emphasized the fact that directors must be found to be people that are trustworthy, with integrity, and must build mutual confidence in their relationship with stakeholders. Keynote speaker at the event, Mr. M.K. Ahmad, commended the IOD Nigeria for aligning its revised Code of Ethics with the Financial Reporting Council of Nigeria 2018 Code of Corporate Governance. He believed the code will help to fast-track the development of good corporate governance across sectors in the economy. In his opening remarks, the president of the IOD Nigeria, Chief Chris Okonomo, said the Code of Ethics standardizes compliance to ethical standards amongst members and induces voluntary compliance. The IOD president said the revised Code of Ethics addresses issues like conflict of interest, gifts and items and hospitality, and the whistleblower policy. The event also featured a panel session moderated by Professor Dion Rosso, with Professor Bolaji Owasanoye, Chairman of the Independent Corrupt Practices and Other Related Offences Commission, ICPC, Mrs. Bola Adeshala, Vice Chairman, Standard Chartered Bank Africa, and Ms. Tinuade Awe, Executive Director of Regulations at the Nigeria Stock Exchange, as panelists. And that will be a wrap on the Week in Review. You can visit our website, www.prochng.com, to watch our videos with our news stories and reports. Till we come your way again, thank you for watching, have a nice day, and stay safe.